Hi everyone and welcome. In this video tutorial, we're going to be performing post-installation configuration on a Windows Server 2012 machine. First thing I need to do is log in by hitting this button that's going to send Control-Alt-Delete. We'll put in our administrative password and wait for the system to come up. Once we're logged in successfully, which we are now, one of the first things we'll see come up is going to be the Server Manager configuration console. And once that's up, we'll start doing some base configuration on our system. One of the things that we're going to be prompted for is, from a networking perspective, do we want to enable on our server going out and hunting around on the network for resources? We do not want to do that, so I will say no. We can see the Server Manager is launching and is now up on our screen. The first thing I want to do as far as configuration is concerned is install VMware Tools, and we're also going to change the host name. The reason I'm going to do both of those at the same time is they require a reboot, so I can do both of those, reboot once, and then save myself a reboot afterwards. To install VMware Tools, I'll launch that first because it takes a little bit longer. Go up to Player, Manage, and Install VMware Tools. As soon as I hit that, it is going to mount the ISO image that will install VMware Tools. We'll see that pop up here. I'll click on that, say that I want to run the setup. We'll give this a minute until the setup comes up and we can answer the prompts. So we'll go off and do the installation and then we will change the host name. Okay, so here's our prompt on the screen. I'm going to take all the defaults and do a typical installation. And it will go and take care of all of that for us. Now, back here in Server Manager, I'm going to select Local Server, which will give us a bunch of properties associated to this installation. And the one I want to focus on right now is the computer name, which is one that's going to be chosen and generated by the installation setup. It's going to select your click on the computer name. It will pop up our system properties. Pardon the screen going black for there for a second. That's part of the VMware Tools installation while it probes the video adapter. It'll come back to us in a second here. All right, there, that's back. It's going to click on change. And a good practice is to make sure the host name matches the VM name. So our VM name is server01. I'm going to change the host name to match that. And I will say OK for that. The system will now probe out onto the network to find out if there's a duplicate host name. As long as it doesn't find one, it will tell us that we're ready to go. It's prompting that we need to restart to apply the changes, meaning that the host name that we've selected is fine. I'll say OK for that. I'll close this and we'll see that it's prompting to restart now. So I'll tell it that it is okay to restart. VMware Tools setup is back. So it says we need to finish. Do I want to restart? So I've got restart prompts now from two different things. One from VMware Tools and then one from changing the host name. I'll pick this guy and say restart. It's going to go through and do a reboot. That'll be back in a couple seconds and then we can go on and finish our post-installation config. Okay, that's back. One of the nice things I can do with VMware Tools is I can now maximize my VM window and you'll notice that it automatically expands to fill all the space. Something you need VMware Tools to do, but it's actually quite nice from that perspective. I'll log back in again as administrator. And then once Server Manager's back up, we'll look at those few other things that we have to do from a post-installation configuration perspective. Right, so server manager is up. I'm going to once again pick on local server. And we'll look at a few of the other items or properties that we're going to want to change. One of them is going to be our time zone. I will select that and change time zone. Set this to Eastern Time. And OK and OK from that. Time zone set is going to be fairly important when later on we work with other software that is going to be time sensitive from authentication, that type of a thing. We see that this hasn't changed immediately. Like with anything, if I do a refresh, then whatever settings we modified will come up. A couple of other things. One is I'm going to want to enable remote desktop. I can't do that right now because we're in the public firewall zone and remote desktop is not usable in that space. So I'm going to change this first. And to do that, I need to use PowerShell. Pop up PowerShell. One of the things I need to do is look at my network connection. Commandlet is get net connection profile. So I just did get netcon and tab, which will do tab completion. Hit enter. I only have one network adapter, which is this guy here. And what I want to do is change this network category from public to private. The way I do that is set net connection profile. I have to specify the adapter that I want. I can do that either through interface alias or name. So if I do dash name and network, and then what I want to do is change the network category. And if I do dash net and hit tab, it's going to auto expand to category. And I'm going to change that to private. And that's all I have to do for that. So once we've changed that to private, I'll just refresh this again. We can see that this is private and we can now enable remote desktop. Come into that. We can see the remote desktop is not enabled at this point in time. I can click on allow. I get a prompt that asks me if it's okay for the ports to be open on the firewall for remote desktop. Yes, that's fine. It's automatically done for me. And then the checkbox that's down on the bottom basically sets the level of security for remote desktop. If I'm only going to be using Microsoft's remote desktop software from Windows 7 Server 2008 and later, I can leave this checked and I'm going to get the highest level of security. If I want to use some third-party tools for remote desktop, I need to clear this because Microsoft essentially has protected the capability for that. And I am going to be using some of those tools, so I'm going to clear that checkbox. Okay, if I do a refresh, we can now see that remote desktop is enabled. I also want to be able to ping this machine, and Microsoft by default blocks inbound pings on IPv4 with the firewall. Make a change to that. I'm going to select on the firewall. Firewall config will come up. I'm going to select advanced settings. And once that comes up, I'm going to look at my inbound rules. When I choose that, the only thing I have to do now is enable the rule. And this might look a wee bit weird, but the actual rule is file and printer sharing and echo request ICMPv4 in. All I have to do is right click on that and enable the rule. I'll just come down here to a different one. We can see that this is now enabled. And that will allow inbound pings on my system. Close out the firewall config. One other thing you might need to do is configure static IP. To do that, I will pick on my network adapter. You can right click, properties, IPv4. And simply punch in the IP address that I want. also need default gateway and DNS server. Okay, okay, and this should now be set up. Close this, do a refresh, and we can see our IP is now configured. One final thing I'll do, and again, this has to do with the network adapter. It's good practice to put a name other than something like Ethernet 0, which doesn't really mean anything to us. I'm just going to pull back up the network connections panel. I'm going to right click on my adapter and rename. And I'll call this production. So now in the future, especially if we have multiple network adapters, we'll be able to look at this name and it'll have some sort of meaning for us rather than just something that says Ethernet 0, Ethernet 1, Ethernet 2. Close that. Again, I'll do one more quick refresh. And we see now that the name of the network adapter is in our properties rather than something generic like Ethernet 0. That's a wrap for the video. Hopefully this is helpful and we'll see you next time.